Hey guys, welcome to the last video in the series. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about one of the libraries that has made my life easy writing React Native apps, and that is React Native Size Matters. So as much as we use Flexbox to manage our layouts in React Native, that really does well in some aspects, but it doesn't do well when we want to scale things like font sizes. So depending on the device, the size of your fonts and other UI widgets would not always look good because every device is different. Every device has different density pixels. So we need a way to really adapt our fonts and all our and the sizes of our widgets to the screen that they are being rendered on. So when faced with problems like those, one of the first things you're going to be thinking of is to use the dimensions that's built into React Native to create a utility that you can use in your app to manage the scale depending on the size of the device. Yeah, so yes, you could do that, but it would take you a lot of work. So I want to introduce you to this library here, React Native Size Matters. So the way it works is basically for every static value to like widths, font sizes, paddings, margins, we can always wrap those inside these utilities. So we have utilities like scale, vertical scale, moderate scale. So most of the times you're going to be using scale. For example, where we have this image here, we're going to now apply a scale so that it now adapts to this kind of, to this very image that it's, to this very device that it's on. So let me go ahead and show you how you can use this module. So down here, I'm going to install it, of course. So I'm going to do yarn add React Native Size Matters down here. And then once it's done, we want to now be wrapping these static values we are setting in the scaling utilities. So I'm going to import the scale here. Okay, so I'll give you an example here. So let's say we were specifying font size. So font size, let's say 21. Let's save this. You notice that it's looking like this. But if we wrap this in scale and save, you see that now it scales to the device it's at. So similarly for this, I'm gonna come over here and also add some padding on the top. So I'm gonna do padding top. Then let me make it 5 now. So if I save, you notice that we get this padding here. But now if we wrap this in scale, so let's do that in scale. You notice that it goes down a bit, and I can prove it when I can now, and we can see it if at least this is big. So if it's in scale, you see it's that. And if we don't have scale on there, you see it goes back up. So this is one way you can use scale when you're like writing inline styles. But most of the times you're not going to be writing inline styles, and you're going to be writing styles in your styles.js file. So the way you can now use this in your styles.js file is here. Instead of us using the style sheet component from React Native, we can use one called scaled sheet. So we can do that, and then it's going to import it from React Native Size Matters. Now, if we save this, nothing will change, and that's because we have not really applied any the utilities to these values here. So over here, if we want to scale this, we want to now wrap it in a string, and then we want to do at s and save. You see that the image now scales. So now we can basically go ahead and repress everything or wherever we had the other scale. So over here, I'm also going to do at s for this and save. So for these font sizes, similarly, we're going to do at s because we want them to already scale to every other device they are being rendered on. So if I save this, you see that now that increases. Let's do this padding too at s. Okay. For the font size, we'll do the same at s. Let's do this padding at s. For the form padding, let's do the same. Okay. Let's also scale this. All right. Let's do the scale here. Change this and save. Should be at s and save, and things are now looking like this. So these are things that you may not really notice before you start to test your app on different devices, but once you test your app on different devices without you doing this adjustment for how fonts would look, you're going to be shocked, and you're going to be really sad when you see how your app will be looking. So this is one of the utilities that I've found very helpful. So for me now, it's like the de facto standard for every app I'm working on. I first set up these and I use them everywhere. So every component, I make sure I am putting in consideration how the fonts and paddings and layouts will scale on every other device. So I hope you found this one helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will talk to you soon.